Hello everybody, welcome to this guided video on how to generate graphs on Excel. So Excel is a Microsoft program that is useful in plotting graphs and doing a lot of mathematical calculations. So at this point, I would like to mention that there is an entire PDF document that has all the information and step-by-step guide that is available on Google Classroom. And at the end of this tutorial, you should have a graph that looks something like this. So let's get started. We want to open a blank workbook on Excel, and then you will see a sheet that appears, and in this sheet basically we can type all our information and type our formulas as well. So let's begin by entering the data in this cell B2, and in the next cell we want to enter a formula. So you have to put an equal to sign, and we want to add the digit 1 to the number here. So let's type B2 plus 1, and so 11 number should appear. So to replicate this entire series, you don't need to enter the formula again. What we need to do is we can take our cursor on the right hand side in the bottom, and you will see it change the sign, and then you can click and drag, and that should replicate the formula and create the remaining cells all the way till 30. Okay, so let's go ahead and create our second column, which is this column C, and basically we will multiply our column B with 3. So let's choose the equal to sign and the cell B2, and to multiply this number you need to use the asterisk sign times 3 and hit enter, and you should see 30 appear. Similarly, instead of typing the formula, you can just click on the cell that you want to multiply and times 3, press enter, and you should see 33 appear. And let's replicate this formula all the way down to the cell C22. So you can check that you have the right numbers. And so let's go ahead and create the column D, and here we are going to create a random number. So you have to type equal to RAND and open and close brackets, and I will multiply this random number that will be generated times 10. So essentially I'm creating some noise, so I can replicate this all the way down to the final cell, and I have a bunch of random numbers that are generated. So now I'll go ahead and create my column E, and in column E basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to add column D and column C. I can replicate this all the way down, and so now I have my entire data set that is being generated. So now I would like to plot this data, and to plot this data what you can do is you can go in the insert tab, it is available on this top left corner of your Excel program, and under insert tab you will see the option of charts that will appear. So we want to choose a scatter plot, so let's choose the first option, and now the plot is empty because we haven't chosen any data. So let's right click and select data, and we want to add the series, so let's click on add, and then we have to choose our x values. So we want to click on this button which is on this right corner, and once you click the button you can choose the values. So I'm going to highlight the entire B column and then click on the button once again, and then to choose the Y values I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to click the button, choose the Y values, and then click on the button back again, and then say OK, and a series should appear here, and then I'm going to click OK once again. So now I have a data that looks like a straight line, so I want to do fitting on this curve, and so I can check and verify the values of x and y axis are correct. So I can highlight the data, again right click, and I would like to add trend line that will do some fitting to this data. So since it's a linear looking data, I have to choose linear in the options available on the right hand side. and I want to see the equation of the line that I am plotting. So let me choose the display equation on chart. And once you do that, you will see the equation will appear on the chart. So this is your y equal to mx plus b equation that you are plotting. So we can right click and say format trend line, and here you can choose the category of the data, scientific, and choose the decimal places if you want. So I can increase the size of this box, and I can also add colors that I want, and I can move around this equation box in my chart area. Okay. So now I'm going to go ahead and work with polynomials. So what we can do is we can create another column G, and in this column we will enter a formula which will be equal to B2 times B2 once again and then divide by 10. And you can replicate this to create the entire series all the way from G2 to G22. And now I want to add this column to my existing chart. So let's go back to the chart area and right click, and it will give you the option of selecting data. And now I want to add a new series. So you want to click on add. And here you can specify the x values. I'm going to keep the same x values that is in the B column. And then for the y values, I'm going to choose my column G. And so now you should see a graph. Just click OK. That appears like a polynomial. Okay. So again, we can choose this data point and click right click on it. That should ask us whether we want to add a trend line to it. And now, since it's not a linear, it's actually a polynomial, we can choose a polynomial. Let's keep the order as 2. And again, I want to see the equation of the chart. So again, my equation is appearing, and it is of the form y equal to some constant times x squared. And again, you can increase the size of the text and you can add the color as well. So I hope now you are comfortable with using Excel to plot the graphs. So in the next set, we will look at the actual data that we have measured and perform some analysis. So if you go to back to your document on activity 2, there is a data set that is given for a body that is falling in free fall because of gravity. So we have the time values measured and the corresponding distance values that the object is moving. So we can use the kinematics equation, which is well known, x equal to v0t plus 1/2 at squared. And we will do a mathematical trick. What we are going to do is divide this equation by time. And on the left hand side, you will see that you get x over t, and on the right hand side, you are left with the equation that says v0 plus 1/2 at. So this equation looks like an equation of a line. So if you plot x over t values on the y axis, and if you plot time on the x axis, you should get a slope m which will be 1/2 a, and you should get b which is your initial velocity. So let's create another sheet and let's enter our data values that we have from our given document. So once you're done entering the data, you can even put the headings of the column if you want. So let's do that. Let's put the time for the column B, and let's put the position for column C. So as I had mentioned earlier, we need X over T values. So let's do that in column D. Let's make the heading. And again, formula, we have to put an equal to sign. Let's choose the value for X, and let's choose the value for time. And there you have it, you have replicated the entire column D. Remember, you have to use the front slash for the division. So now we can again plot a scatter plot, and in this scatter plot again we can look at the data. It is linear as expected, and we can choose the X and Y series. So for the X value, I want time, so let me choose that. And I'm okay with the Y values already. And I can even put a name for this series that I want. So I'm trying to find acceleration. And so now I can do right click and do the fitting by using trend line option. And now I want to keep linear, and I want to see the equation. And this equation is my Y equal to mx plus b equation of a line. So as we were discussing earlier, this slope here that is given by 4.8716, this value is half times your acceleration. So to calculate acceleration, what you want to do is you want to multiply this number by 2, and there you have it. 9.74 is your value for acceleration due to gravity in meter per second square. So I hope this video was helpful for you in understanding what you can do with Excel in terms of data analysis and plotting graphs. Thank you so much.